Welcome to this week's Pascal's China Lens. And just 2 weeks ago, I moderated a virtual safari organized by Mastercard. And one of the guest speakers was Mirko Wermuth. And he explained the whole story of Pinduoduo, a company I've been following for many years and which I really believe we have to understand what they're doing, because Pinduoduo is disrupting this global e-commerce market today. So today we're going to talk about this company called Pinduoduo. And so in Chinese, these characters, pin actually means sharing or group, like group buying. And duoduo actually means a lot. So together it means bundling together. And so this is really about group buying. But this company, Pinduoduo, in just 5 years' time, they went from zero, because the company is 5 years old, from zero to $100 billion in revenue. I mean, this is amazing. There's no other company that has done that before them. They came out of nothing. They're worth $180 billion right now in valuation. Now, this company is really amazing. And many people say, if you want to understand the future of global e-commerce, try to understand what Pinduoduo is about. Now, some people describe it as a combination of Disney and Costco. And so Disney, of course, we know that that's all about entertainment, and Costco is all about low price and lots of choice. And so the combination of both is quite interesting. Now, if we look at the history, Colin Huang, the founder of Pinduoduo, 5 years ago, he actually was still working for a company that was doing gaming. And before that, he was part of Google. So he's been coming from the gaming industry. And that explains the Disney component of this whole thing. But Pinduoduo has really come up with a great idea. Colin Huang, in 2015, he thought, there's 1 billion people in China on WeChat, the Tencent product, the social media of China. But there's only 500 million buying online on Alibaba or JD.com, the competitor of Alibaba. Where are the other 500 million people? Where are they left? Why are they not buying? They're on social, they have a smartphone, but they're not buying. And so he figured out in 2015, when he launched a company, that there's 500 million people or more in third and fourth and fifth tier cities in China that weren't really buying online. And so he was wondering, what do these people want and what can I offer them? And that's how Pinduoduo came about. Now, one of the things that they care about, of course, is good price, because this is a lower income cities or towns. So he thought price is critical. So he thought buying in group buying would really solve this problem. So that was all about volume. He wanted to create volume. And so his whole concept of Pinduoduo was all about creating lots of volume. Then he thought, what are these people buying? Well, they buy a lot of things for household. Think about vegetables and fruit and meat and all these things that you need very frequently. That just doesn't bring you volume. It actually brings you consumers that are coming back regularly if they are on your site. So he focused on agricultural products and not on high tech or all things like iPhones, just like JD.com did, or Alibaba did a lot with fashion and so on. No. Agriculture, the hard work, that's what he did. And the third thing, he figured out that in most households in China, it's the women that actually decide the purchases of what to buy for the household. So he was focusing on group buying, was focusing on frequent purchases, agriculture, and targeted to women. And that was the whole concept. And so he knew price was critical. But in order for people to not just go and buy on e-commerce like they do now, he thought, maybe I should create an environment where it's not about searching for products, it's about making these products available and then having what he calls impulse buying. And so think about it like a sushi conveyor belt in a Japanese restaurant, where there's all these products coming in front of you. And from time to time you say, oh, that's an interesting product. That's an interesting fish I would like to have, or sushi I would like to eat, or sashimi. So I'll take that one. And that's the concept of Pinduoduo. It's about just letting it float by. And then just from time to time, you actually want it. And why do you want it? Why do you buy it? because of recommendations. So Pinduoduo created an environment of friends and family recommending these products. And why would they do that? Because they can get better discounts. And so you can find individual sales. So you can buy a product like vegetable or fruit at a specific price. But if you want to get better price, you have two ways to get that. First of all, this group buying is only 24 hours for each product. So within 24 hours, you have to decide, am I buying it or am I not buying it? So if you do, you can either join an existing group or you can create your own. And if you create your own, that means you need to recommend people, your friends, your family, to actually join in, to chip in and buy together more vegetables, more fruit, more paper or tissue or whatever it is that you need for your household. And that's the whole concept of Pinduoduo. Now he thought, let's gamify this. And that's because of his past of Colin Huang, of coming from the gaming industry. He said, if I now make this fun, then really people are going to buy this because they want to be part of this game. And so his idea was very simple. He said, I'm going to try and make lots of games and I'm going to start from social. I'm going to start from WeChat, because WeChat is where there's a billion consumers. That's where your friends and family are. And now you need to reach them and play games together. And so he created flash sales, he created lotteries, he created recommendation games, but also even virtual games where if you win, you get actual real products like vegetables or fruit. So this was a fun way of people to engage, to interact. And that's why we call it the interactive mobile e-commerce platform of today. Now, this is all very well, and this company grew like crazy because he really touched a niche market of a billion people almost, that were all wanting to get better products, have fun, share it with their colleagues or share it with their friends, and basically have a good time. But what's interesting to know about Pinduoduo is that it created a trend. It actually disrupted the complete supply chain, the manufacturing, because now we're talking with Pinduoduo about consumer to manufacturing, C2M. What that means is that this whole middleman between the consumer and the brand and the factories is actually getting disrupted. Now, these brands that usually were telling the factories what to produce and then selling them through retailers online or offline is completely being disrupted by Pinduoduo, who knows much better than these factories or the brands what the market wants. And so there's no more need for marketing, there's no more need for research. Basically, Pinduoduo can tell the factories directly, without the brands, to actually what the consumer wants. And that means that these factories are becoming extremely smart with the insights of Pinduoduo. And so smart factory of tomorrow in this concept might actually mean that it's a smart market of tomorrow rather than a smart factory of tomorrow. And so the markets are getting smarter than the factories, and the factories can now become brands on themselves because they can brand whatever they build based on the market needs or market demand. So a complete different model. Now, the second thing that's interesting in that C2M model, so consumer to manufacturing model, is that agriculture is central to it. And that was because all these household women, they actually wanted to buy these vegetables and fruits and so on. And so they needed that fresh produce from Pinduoduo's producers, which are the farmers. And so these farmers now for the very first time had a platform that they could actually live stream and promote their products towards consumers everywhere, and people could buy in group together to get better discounts together. That optimized actually the whole supply chain, because now Pinduoduo could take care of this, sending it from the farmer directly to the consumer in his home, at his house, and deliver one basket of peaches or apples directly from the manufacturer, from the farmer, without all the hassle of brands and marketing and all that distribution network in between. And so live streaming really became hot there. What's interesting is that the Chinese government, local governments and central governments everywhere, were helping Pinduoduo to actually help these farmers get out of poverty even faster. So it had a social meaning on top of it. And so this is why this company in just 5 years' time, became the biggest competitor of Alibaba and is a company that is disrupting the e-commerce worldwide, especially in China, but now the rest of the world will also look at Pinduoduo as a model. Because the model is extremely well, because somehow they figured out how to serve the underserved of China, and we can do the same for the rest of the world. This is about combining fun, about social, about commerce. It's about creating better value for both the farmer or the producer as well as for the consumer, and ultimately have great logistics. So I see no reason why this Pinduoduo concept, this model, which is very unique, wouldn't go global at one point, because in China you see every e-commerce platform now copying their model, so I'm sure the rest of the world will too. So if we want to understand the future of e-commerce in the world, Pinduoduo is the company to look at. If you want to understand how your market, your industry, could get disrupted by this new concept, this new model of combining Disney, the entertainment, with a better value and the underserved of the world, then Pinduoduo is definitely the company to look into. Hope you liked it, and see you next week for another episode of Pascal's China Lens.